In this video, you will learn how to start and stop the S100 AC drive. Start methods include ACC and DC start. Stopping methods include DEC, DC brake, free run, and power braking. ACC is the normal acceleration method. If no other function is selected, the vehicle will accelerate to the target frequency when a driving command is entered, reflecting the acceleration time. DC start accelerates after applying direct current voltage to the motor. The DEC stop method is a common deceleration stop method. If no other function is selected, the motor will decelerate to 0 Hz to reflect the deceleration time and then stop. The DC brake stop method can be used if you want to stop the motor by applying DC voltage at a set frequency during deceleration. The free run stop method is a function that cuts off the inverter output when the drive command is turned off. The power braking stop method is a control method that adjusts the deceleration slope or accelerates again to reduce the regenerative energy when the AC drive DC voltage rises above a certain level due to the motor regenerative energy. Start and stop methods can be set to suit the characteristics of your facility for loads that use mechanical brakes, such as fans, pumps, lifts, elevators, etc. Let's see how to set the start method. The ACC acceleration start method is a general acceleration method. If no other function is selected, the AC drive will accelerate to the target frequency by reflecting the acceleration time when the operation command is input. Set by selecting 0 ACC in start mode AD7. The DC start starting method accelerates after applying direct current voltage to the motor for the set time of the DC start time. If the motor is rotating before the voltage is output from the AC drive, DC braking will stop the motor rotation and then accelerate. It can also be used when a constant torque is required, even after opening the machine brake under vertical loads using a machine brake on the motor shaft. The DC braking amount of DC injection level can be set based on the motor rated current, and should be set to a value within the AC drive rated current. Select DC start as number 1 in AD7 start mode. When DC start is set, DC start time in AD12 and DC injection level in AD3 are activated. At AD12 DC start time, press enter and use the arrow keys to set the time. The time setting can be set from 0 to 60 seconds, depending on the condition of the equipment. At AD13 DC injection level, press the Enter key to set the DC injection level. Use the arrow keys to set the level and press Enter to complete the setting. The DC injection level can be set from 0 to 200% depending on the machine condition. Let's see how to set the stop method. The DEC stop method is a general deceleration stop method, and if no other function is selected, the deceleration time will be affected by the deceleration time to slow down to 0 Hz and then stop. Let's see how to set the DEC stop using the keypad. In the AD8 stop mode, press the Enter key to set the stop method. Use the arrow keys to move to 0 DEC and press Enter to complete the setting. The DC brake stop method is used for high-speed spindle motors, which can move slightly due to high-speed inertia even after stopping, to apply direct current braking to bring the motor to a complete stop. Select one DC brake in stop mode at AD8. The frequency set in AD17 DC brake frequency will apply DC voltage to the motor and stop it when it reaches that frequency level during deceleration. AD14 DC block time is to set the time to block the AC drive output before starting DC braking. AD15 DC brake time is to set the time to apply DC voltage to the motor. AD16 DC brake level is to set the amount of DC braking based on the motor's current rating. Let's see how to set the DC brake stop using the keypad. In AD8 stop mode, press the Enter key to bring up a screen where you can set the stop method. Move the cursor to DC brake 1 and press Enter to activate the parameters for deceleration. At AD14 DC block time, press Enter to bring up a screen for setting the time. Use the arrow keys to set the time and press the Enter key to finalize the setting. The AC drive output block time setting can be set from 0 to 60 seconds, depending on the machinery condition. At AD15 DC brake time, press the Enter key and the screen appears where you can set the time. Use the arrow keys to set the time and press Enter to finalize the setting. The DC voltage supply time setting can be set from 0 to 60 seconds, depending on the facility conditions. At AD16 DC brake level, press Enter to display the screen for setting the DC brake amount. Use the arrow keys to set the amount and press Enter to finalize the setting. The brake amount can be set from 0 to 200% depending on the facility condition. At AD17 DC brake frequency, press Enter to display the screen for setting the frequency. Use the arrow keys to set it and press the Enter key to finalize the setting. The DC brake start frequency setting can be set from 0 to 60 Hz, depending on the equipment condition. The free run stop method is a function that cuts off the AC drive output when the operation command is turned off. Even if the AC drive output is cut off, the motor may rotate under the inertia of the load for a long time if the motor has a large inertia and is running at high speed. Free run stop is a function that cuts off the AC drive output when stopped, creating the same effect as a facility running on direct input. Let's take a look at how to set up a free run stop using the keypad. At AD8 stop mode, press the Enter key to bring up a screen where you can set the stop method. Use the arrow keys to move the cursor to free run number 2. And press the Enter key to finish setting the free run function. The power braking stop method controls the deceleration gradient or re-acceleration to reduce the regenerative energy when the AC drive DC voltage rises above a certain level due to motor regenerative energy. It can be set and used when a short deceleration time is required without a separate braking resistor and braking unit. Please note that the deceleration time may be longer than the set deceleration time, and when used for loads with frequent deceleration, burnout may occur due to motor overheating. Let's see how to set the stop after DC braking using the keypad. In the AD8 stop mode, press the Enter key to display the screen for setting the stop method. Use the arrow keys to move to 4 power braking and press Enter to complete the power braking settings. This section explains how to start and stop the S100. Thank you.